Dear students, I am Manjunath, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology, Government First Aid College, Kolar. Students, in the previous classes, we studied about the Eurochordata. That Eurochordata, we studied the Ascidian. In this class, we shall study about the Cephalochordata and Cephalochordata. So we study Hampiaxis. Morphology of Hampiaxis. Hampiaxis is commonly known as lancelet or lancet because of the pointed lance-like ends of the body. It was first discovered by P.S. Pillon in 1778. It was in 1834 that O.G. Costa recognized its true position in the animal kingdom and named it as Branchiostoma lanceolatus. Yarrell in 1836 named it as Hampiaxis lanceolatus. It has a transparent spindle-like body, laterally compressed, and looks like lens, means pointed at both the ends. When come to the systematic position, so the Hampiaxis belongs to the phylum Chordata, subphylum Cephalochordata, and class Leptochordae, and family Brachiostomidae, genus Branchiostoma. It is commonly called as Hampiaxis. Hampiaxis is cosmopolitan in distribution, found in marine shallow water of sandy coast in tropical and temperate region. It is a burrowing and nocturnal animal. The Branchiostoma is about the Branchiostoma is about 3.5 to 6 centimeter in length. The body is slender, somewhat translucent, that means semi-transparent, superficially fish-like, means it looks like fish, and laterally compressed and pointed at both the ends, hence the name lancelet. The anterior two-thirds of the body is roughly triangular in transverse section. The posterior third is nearly oval in section. The pointed end of the anterior end of the trunk projects in front to form a rostrum or snout. Below the rostrum is an oral hood, which is formed by the dorsal and lateral projections of the body, and it bears 20 or more stiff oral cirri or buccal cirri or tentacles. The body of the Hampiaxis has two divisions, the anterior trunk and the posterior tail. But the true head is absent. Branchiostoma has three unpaired pins. They are dorsal pin, caudal pin, and ventral pin. The paired pins like pectoral and pelvic pins are absent. Along the mid-dorsal side of the body is a dorsal fin running all along the length of the body. It is joined to form a caudal fin around the tail, and mid-ventrally it runs to form a ventral fin, which runs up to the atriophore. The dorsal fin is supported by a series of fin rays and nerves, the ventral fin by a series of paired fin rays. The fin rays are lacking in caudal fin, means caudal fin has no fin rays. Pins do not have same structure as the pins of fishes. It has a pins, but the pins are not like that of pins of fishes. The oral hood is continuous posteriorly. This oral hood is continuous posteriorly with two lateral membranes, hollow metapleural folds, which are running ventrally up to the atriophore. The body wall shows metameric segmentation. So, which is made up of, so horizontal V-shaped blocks of muscles called as the myotomes. Beneath the myotomes, on both the sides are present a series of gonads between the mouth and the atriophore. Means in between the mouth and the atriophore, so there is a series of gonads. Below the pointed anterior extremity is a large median aperture. The mouth. So here is the mouth. This below the pointed anterior extremity is a large median aperture, the mouth, which is surrounded by the oral hood. Immediately in front of the anterior end, of the ventral pin, so he is surrounded an aperture called as the atriopore. So a short distance from the posterior extremity of the body is the anus. Okay, here is the short distance from the posterior extremity of the body is the anus. The post anal portion of the body is called as the thymus. Means the post anal region of the body is called as the thymus. So the muscles are present beneath the body wall, which exhibit metameric segments. The muscles are there, which are present below the or beneath the body wall, which exhibits metameric segmentation. Muscle here consists of number of about 60 to 60 myotomes, means many myotomes. Their number is around 60 to 62, which are separated by myocomas. These myotomes are separated by myocomas, which are directed forward. They are all V-shaped, horizontal V-shaped, which are directed forwards. Contractions of these segmental muscles or myotomes cause side-to-side bending of the body with the animal swims. The myotomes of two sides of the animal do not correspond but are placed alternatively. Means these myotomes of either side of the body, they are not correspond but they are placed alternatively. On the dorsal side of the myotomes enclosing the nerve cord, and notochord, this is the characteristics of vertebrates. Okay, so till now we have studied about the morphology, the external features of the humpy axis. Okay, thank you all.